Good evening. I think we had some streaming issue in the previous link, so I had to break it up, and this is our new link. So today's topic, so 7:30 p.m. we'll have a topic discussion of preventive protocol for dental caries, right? So it will be more or less like a Q&A session where we'll have a lot of discussion rather than me explaining the whole topic, right? Because most of us are familiar with different levels of prevention and various measures which can be taken at different levels of prevention. So today's topic will be preventive protocol for dental caries. Hi Pradhan, Subhasish, Sanjay, hi, a very good evening. So can you tell me what are the different levels of prevention? How many levels of prevention do we have? I mean, you might have come across the same topic in the public health industry or periodontics. So what are the different levels of prevention? Exactly. Hi Mubashir, Kiran, hi, very good evening. Yes, Sanjay, so we have primary, secondary and tertiary. So based on the hierarchy of needs, we have primary, secondary and tertiary, isn't it? So let me just mention the same here. Primary, secondary and tertiary. So these are various levels of prevention, and also we have various prevention services. Can you give me some examples for prevention services? Since you said different levels of prevention, what are the different services which fall under these levels of prevention? Let me just give you one example. Health promotion. So health promotion falls under prevention services, and it also falls under primary a level of prevention, isn't it? So can you give me more such examples? Yes, fluoride application, ART, they are more specific, but we're talking in general, the different categories, prevention services. Yes, fluoride application, ART, diet counseling, they're all specific examples which we'll discuss further. But can you give me different categories which fall under prevention services? One is health promotion. And you might have heard of this term, specific protection. And also there are numerous multiple choice questions on this area. Isn't it? Health promotion, specific protection. So these two fall under primary level of prevention. This is very important, make a note of it. And what comes under secondary level of prevention? Hi Swamiya, very good evening. Hi Naini, Shridevi, hi. So this session will be more or less like a Q&A session, and we are discussing on the topic preventive protocol for dental caries. So we have different levels of prevention and different categories in each level of prevention, right? So in primary level of prevention, we have health promotion and specific protection. What about secondary level of prevention? Early diagnosis, yes, hi Shafiro, very good evening, so early diagnosis, limitation of the disease or dental caries, or prompt treatment fall under secondary level of prevention. Right? And what about tertiary level of prevention? Tertiary level of prevention. I'm sure we can answer this. What about disability limitation? Have you heard of the term disability limitation? Disability limitation, rehabilitation. So all these fall under tertiary levels of prevention. Yes, Prerna, you say educating the patient, specific water fluoridation. Okay, these are specific examples which you're talking about, right? Yes, we'll definitely discuss all those things. Hi, Radhu, very good evening. So, as I mentioned previously, today we are going to focus on the topic preventive protocol for dental caries, wherein we will be discussing several measures which can be taken to either prevent or limit or treat dental caries. So we have different levels of prevention, as you rightly mentioned, primary, secondary and tertiary. So also make sure you note down alongside with me, as you will be covering many important points. So in each level of prevention, you have prevention services again. So health promotion and specific protection fall under primary level of prevention. In fact, we had several questions from this specific protection and the examples in various entrances previously. And secondary level of prevention, early diagnosis, limitation of disease and prompt treatment fall under secondary level of prevention. And disability limitation and rehabilitation or delivering a processes, for example, fall under tertiary levels of prevention. So what I have given you now is just the overview and the basic matrix. Now we'll have a discussion pertaining to various services and categories they fall under. So I'll be giving you numerous examples. All you have to do is listen to those examples carefully and fit them like where they appropriately can be placed. For example, if I say fluoride application, so where does it or in which category does it fall under? If I say delivery of FPD, in which category does it fall under? If I say root canal treatment, in which category does it fall under? So all you have to do is fit in the right category based on the examples which I quote, right? So that it will be more enjoyable and fun in learning. Fine? I hope I have made myself clear. So we'll start with the first one, diet planning or diet counseling. So diet planning or diet counseling falls under which prevention service? Or which category? So we'll start with diet planning or diet counseling. And you have to be more specific, not just fitting it into the right level of prevention, but also try to fit that in the right prevention service. So diet counseling, does it come under primary, secondary or tertiary? Or does it come under in specific health promotion, specific protection, early diagnosis, rehabilitation, etc.? Good. Exactly. So diet counseling or diet planning falls under health promotion, primary level of prevention, isn't it? Okay. What about hi Gaushini, very good evening. Hi Dhan Lakshmi, Chavi. What about periodic dental visits? Regular dental visits. We ask patient to come or to visit a dentist every 3 months or maybe every 6 months or twice a year. So periodic dental visits fall under which category? early diagnosis? Early diagnosis comes later, isn't it? Periodic dental visits also fall under health promotion, preventive, isn't it? Yes. Periodic dental visits fall under health promotion in primary level of prevention. Yes, it's health promotion again. Good. And you have been mentioning about various sealants. What about pit and fissure sealants? Pit and fissure sealants. In which category does pit and fissure sealants fall under? Is it primary, secondary, or tertiary? Are we trying to limit in pit and fissure sealants, or are we trying to promote elimination or prevention as such? Yes, this is very important. Pit and fissure sealants come under specific protection, primary level of prevention. So we seal pit and fissures even before initiation of caries. So they come under specific protection. So primary level of prevention. Yes, good. Yes, Ujma, Mubashir, Subhasish, Radhu, Priyadana, Sridevi. Okay, fine. So I won this time. Let's see the next one. What about school water fluoridation? Or community water fluoridation. In which category does it fall under? School or community water fluoridation? I want you to be fast so that we still have a lot many examples to cover. Water fluoridation, is it a kind of health promotion like diet planning, or are we trying to protect specifically? Exactly. Specific protection. Even community water fluoridation or school water fluoridation fall under specific protection in primary level of prevention. I think and I hope you can correlate, right? Yes. Since you have this propensity and most of you are saying primary health promotion, okay, let me give you another example. Dental camps, which you conduct, dental awareness camps. So in which category does it fall under? Dental awareness camps or oral hygiene awareness camps, which we usually undertake during our undergraduation. Or even post-graduation, or even after establishing clinical practice. Dental awareness camps. Obviously, it has to be health promotion, isn't it? So awareness camps also fall under health promotion, primary level of prevention, right? If you assume this to be a hierarchy or a triangle, you'll have something like this. I hope you can see. So at the base of the triangle, you'll have primary. And in the middle, you'll have secondary. And the summit or the peak is tertiary. Something like that. Primary, secondary, and tertiary. I think it's not so clear, right? Yes, another example. Clock control program. Clock control program. Clock control program. Maybe in public health industry camps or in perio camps, you might have done this clock control program. Clock control also comes under health promotion. Not specific protection. Brushing maybe can be considered as specific protection, but clock control, health promotion, awareness. Okay, this is tricky. Let's see how many of you are going to answer. Complete oral examination falls under which category? Complete oral examination. Don't worry if you are getting confused. I'll try to summarize. In fact, I'll summarize at the end of the video. I mean, before concluding the session, right? So don't worry even if you're answering wrong. We'll get more clarity by the time we conclude the session. Complete oral examination. Impressive. So complete oral examination falls under early diagnosis, a secondary level of prevention. Complete oral examination. Yes. What about pulp capping procedures? Direct pulp capping or indirect pulp capping? Pulp capping procedures. Do they fall under primary, secondary, or tertiary? Pulp capping. Is it disability limitation, or is it rehabilitation, or is it prompt treatment? Pulp capping. So if you know the objectives of each of these treatments, it will be crystal clear for you and you can easily categorize them. Fair enough? You're getting frustrated? Very good. Dhanlakshmi, Chavi, Radhu, Prerna, Sridevi, Kiran, Bashir. Yes. Prompt treatment. That's true. So pulp capping procedures fall under prompt treatment, secondary level of prevention. What about root canal treatment, RCT? Root canal treatment, in which category does it fall under? Yes, Kiran, it has to be confusing. Only then you will get more clarity. Let it be confusing. As I said, I'll summarize once again so that you will have more clarity. Just remember, just visualize the objective of the treatment. Why do you do pulpotomy? It's not you're trying to limit the disability. You're promptly addressing the status of the pulp in order to preserve the vitality, isn't it? So pulpotomy or any pulp capping fall under prompt treatment. You are in fact limiting the pathology, right? So try to visualize and understand the objective of the treatment. It will be crystal clear for you. Yes, root canal treatment. Yes, root canal treatment falls under disability limitation. What about class 1 amalgam restoration, or for that matter, simple restorative procedures? So root canal falls under disability limitation. What about a class 1 amalgam restoration? Is it prompt treatment, or is it disability limitation, or is it rehabilitation? Yes. All simple restorative procedures. Simple restorative procedures fall under secondary or prompt treatment. Right? What about pin retained amalgam restoration? Previously I said class 1 amalgam and you mentioned that it falls under secondary, right? What about pin retained amalgam restoration or complex amalgam restoration? Which category does it fall under? Exactly. Good. Already there is loss of cusp. There is disability. You are further trying to limit the disability. Complex restorations fall under. Disability limitation, tertiary. Just now you said it's confusing, then how come you're answering it so well? Okay, good. What about implants? Implants. Yes, Akriti. So it's obvious, implants or any processes for that matter, CD, FPD, RPD or a crown, they fall under rehabilitation. Right, any processes fall under rehabilitation. Good. What about extraction? Extraction. Just imagine, what if you don't extract tooth? What can happen if you leave out a grossly decayed tooth or a tooth which is having an abscess, for example? So extraction falls under. Fantastic. Disability limitations. Yes. PRR, preventive resin restorations. Just remember, simple restorations or even PRR, preventive resin restorations, fall under prompt treatment. Plus PRR, preventive resin restoration. What about fluoride tablets? Fluoride mouthwash? Anything that has to do with fluoride? Water fluoridation or anything that has to do with fluoride? Fluoride supplements. In fact, we will have one video on fluoride supplements in e-classes by tomorrow. Fluoride supplements. Just remember, any processes, rehabilitation, anything to do with fluoride, it will be specific protection, right? Good. And finally, caries activity test. Caries activity test, which category does it fall under? It has to be even before early diagnosis, caries activity test, to promote health, to explain patient that this is the situation in your oral cavity. These are the number of microorganisms you are having. So it's a kind of health promotion, just like diet counseling, awareness programs, plaque programs, plaque control programs, even caries activity test falls under health promotion, right? CAT, caries activity tests. So that's what I'm saying. If you know the purpose of a particular test or a particular treatment, then it will be easy for you to understand and to remember it forever. Previously I said periodic visit to a dentist falls under health promotion. What about periodic screening and referral of patient? As a doctor, you go to community, a particular community, you screen the people in that particular community on a periodic basis, every 3 months or every 6 months. What does it come under? It's just like complete oral examination. So periodic screening and referral comes under which category? Yes, early diagnosis. Whereas a patient's visit to a dentist once in 6 months or twice in a year, health promotion. Whereas periodic screening and referral falls under early diagnosis, limitation, prompt treatment. Right? Exactly. So these are numerous examples which I wanted to quote, right? So before we conclude, I'll summarize once again all that we have discussed so far. So preventive protocol for dental caries. So how do you prevent, how do you treat, or how do you limit the spread of disease? So we have different levels of prevention as per the hierarchy, primary, secondary, and tertiary. Tertiary will always be at the peak of the pyramid. So primary, again, you have health promotion and specific protection. Often we assume that specific protection falls under tertiary, but be cautious when you're answering questions based on specific protection, right? So in fact, I made a mistake previously during my entrance. That's the reason I remember it even much better now. So in primary, you have health promotion and specific protection. In secondary, you have early diagnosis, limitation, and prompt treatment. And tertiary, you have disability limitation, rehabilitation. And the examples, numerous examples, health promotion, you have diet counseling, periodic dental visits, awareness camps, plaque control, caries activity tests. Specific protection, anything, everything to do with fluorides, pit and fissure sealants, water fluoridation, fluoride supplements, etc. In secondary, early diagnosis, limitation, and prompt treatment, these are the objectives. So complete oral examination, periodic screening and referral, preventive resin restorations, pulp capping, simple respiratory procedures, class 1s, class 2s, all this fall under secondary. And tertiary, you have disability limitation, where you're trying to limit the disability. It can be either extraction or it can be either root canal treatment or complex restorations. And rehabilitation, any artificial processes, implants, FPD, RPD, minor tooth movements, crowns, etc. Right? So these are various preventive protocols for dental caries. Right? I hope it's clear. Lobby efforts, I haven't heard of it, Prerna. Just refer and also drop a mail. I'll see if I can check it out. Fine. I hope this session is thought-provoking, just remember, if it is confusing, always consider that as a good sign. Because when something is confusing, you have an opportunity to get more clarity. And once you get more clarity, you will grow more confident. So if everything is fine, smooth, and polished, then there is no real fun. So it has to be confusing. You should understand the confusing part. You should try to get more clarity. And obviously, that's going to improve your levels of confidence, right? I hope this session has eventually improved your level of confidence rather than the other way around. Fine. So even Toffee was barking previously, asking me to conclude the session fast because it's been already 35 minutes. And also, we planned another session at 9:30 p.m. tonight, but we'll do it tomorrow. We have a set of MCQs to be discussed. I have posted those MCQs in Google Group, so you can refer that. You can download it in the form of soft copy. And it's also available in the form of surprise test number 19 for all our registered students. So complete the test, you'll have discussion part tomorrow. So tomorrow at 7:30 p.m. we'll have discussion of those 5 MCQs along with one general multiple choice question or a general knowledge question. Fine? So anyways, I'll leave you an update in WhatsApp group and Google group. Yes, Prerna, you say Kerry's activity test falls under specific protection. My reference, Pido Shobhatandon, says it is health promotion. Okay, I'll refer that and I'll get back to you. If at all any correction is needed, I will drop it in the description of this video itself. Prerna, whatever questions you have posed, please drop a mail. We'll definitely have a discussion. Fine? Okay then. See you again tomorrow at 7:30 p.m. for MCQs discussion. Right. So enjoy preparation, give your best, I'm sure you will rock. So the most important thing is never to lose enthusiasm. As long as you have the enthusiasm to learn. In fact, when I asked a few of you to get back with compliance reports, I can see a lot of enthusiasm in filling the reports. That's very important. So enthusiasm is always the key and it helps you raise your standards and you will definitely enjoy what you're doing. And which is in turn key for success, right? Yeah. I hope you enjoyed the session and I hope I haven't left you in a confused state. And I hope you are having much more clarity over the topics which you have discussed now. If you have any further queries, you can drop a mail 24/7 at proudtobedentist@gmail.com with proper references, right? I hope you're doing. So wish you all the best. Love you all. Take care. Bye.